students, in the previous lecture we have studied about galvanometer damping mechanism, that is how much external resistance should be added in the circuit so that damping of the galvanometer becomes a steady state operation, that is it should be zero damping. So on the basis of that topic, here we will solve a numerical. So first of all, read the numerical and write the given data. That is, the coil of a moving coil galvanometer has 300 turns. That what is given? Given value n is equals to 300 and is suspended in a uniform magnetic field of 0.1 Weber per meter square. That is, it is given flux density. That is, flux density B is equals to 0.1 Weber per meter square. And next, the control constant is 0.2 into 10 to the power minus 6 Newton meter per radian. That is, here is your control constant is your K. That is 0.2 into 10 to the power minus 6 Newton meter per radian. That is your K value. Now, the coil is 2 cm wide and 2.5 cm high. That is, it is your width and length of the coil. So, you can calculate area is equals to 2 into 2.5 cm is given. You have to convert into meter. That is, upon 100. Here, the value is coming 0.005 meter square. Now next, what is given? The coil, it is with a moment of inertia of 0.15. that moment of inertia is your J value. That is 0.15 into 10 to the power minus 6 kg meter square. Now, if the galvanometer constant is 250 ohm, that is galvanometer constant. What is the galvanometer constant? That is, if the galvanometer constant, sorry for that, it is not constant, it will be resistance. That is, galvanometer resistance is 250 ohm. That is, Rg is equals to 250 ohm. Now, calculate the value of resistance which when connected across the galvanometer terminals will give the critical damping. That is, it, what is it asking? It is external resistance R you have to find. Re, external resistance. So from here we can calculate the value. A is given and B is also given, and your constant, controlling constant K is given, and number of turns N is given. So you can easily find the value of G, that is NBA. As you know, put the value 300 into B is your 0.1 and area is your 0.005. That is, it is coming after calculation is 0.015 Newton meter per ampere. Now, G has been calculated. So, you have to find the total critical resistance, critical damping resistance. As in the previous lecture, I have calculated the value of RC, critical damping resistance, which is G square upon 2 root under KJ. In the previous lecture, I have calculated this value. So, put the all given data. Here is g 0.015 to the whole square upon 2 root under k is your given value 0.2 into 10 to the power minus 6 and j is your 0.15 into 10 to the power minus 6. And from this you can calculate the critical damping resistance RC and it is coming that 650 ohm. Now we have to calculate the external resistance for the critical damping. So external resistance I have calculated in the previous lecture, RE is equals to RC minus of RG, and RG is your given value 250 ohm and RC has been calculated 650 minus 250, that is it is coming 400 ohm. It is your external resistance added in the circuit for critical damping. So similar like that, simple questions or numerical can be asked in the university exams. Now coming to the next topic, that is galvanometer constants, or it has also known as sensitivity of the galvanometer. As we have already studied different types of constant as G, K, theta and damping constant DM, and similarly another is the sensitivity constant. As the damping constant and controlling constant is not given in the specification, you have to know the sensitivity constants or in the terms of current sensitivity, voltage sensitivity of the instrument, you should know. So first one is your sensitivity is defined in terms of the current, voltage, megohm and the ballistic sensitivity. There are four types of sensitivity. First one is your current sensitivity. As it is defined as the deflection caused by unit current across the galvanometer, or it is defined as SI is equals to theta F upon I. Theta is your deflection and I is your current applied. So it is unit current. As we know, theta F equals to G I upon K. So put the value and it is SI equals to G upon K radian per ampere. It is also defined as, in case of a galvanometer attached with a mirror, it is the deflection in mm produced on a scale at a distance of 1 meter from the galvanometer mirror by unit current. As I have already told in the previous lecture, as when a mirror is put and it is your scale and deflection, it should be placed 1 meter away from the galvanometer, this mirror, and deflection caused by the 2 theta on the scale. Deflection caused angle of 2 theta and it is 1 meter away and the scale is placed in a mm, 1 mm. So it is the D is the deflection on the scale per unit current and it is in mm and it should be in micro ampere. So it is also defined as D upon I into 10 to the power 6 mm per microampere, and D is your deflection on the scale. So if deflection is theta, then on the mirror deflected by 2 theta falling on the scale. So D can be calculated, that is 1 meter away, it is converted into mm, that is 1000 into 2 theta of the deflection. So 2000 into theta. So put the value of D here, SI will be this value coming as a theta upon 500 I, and put the value of theta, so it is G upon 500 K, and K is your controlling constant. It is your current sensitivity. Now voltage sensitivity. Similarly, in the current sensitivity, deflection caused per unit current, and in the voltage sensitivity, deflection in the scale division caused by unit voltage applied across the galvanometer. So it is denoted by SV, sensitivity, voltage sensitivity, and it is deflection caused by unit voltage. That is, put the value of V is equals to IR, current flowing across the galvanometer, and R is the total resistance of the galvanometer. So for a galvanometer with a scale 1 meter from the mirror and one scale division equals to 1 mm, then SV is equals to G upon 500 kr. That is, here D, put the value of, we have calculated here, that is putting the value of D, 2000 into theta, G upon 500 k is coming. So this value is putted here, G upon 500 k, and R is your resistance of the galvanometer. So it can be converted into current sensitivity, that is voltage sensitivity is equals to G into current sensitivity upon resistance of the galvanometer. Now third one is your Magon sensitivity. That is, what is it defines? The resistance required in mega ohm in the circuit to cause the deflection of one scale division on impressing one voltage is called the Magon sensitivity. That is, one scale deflection is produced by applying the one voltage across the galvanometer. That is called as Magon sensitivity. It is denoted as S naught is equals to deflection divided by 1 volt, that is 1 volt into 10 to the power 6 Magon per scale division. So for 1 meter away and 1 mm per division, it is S naught equals to G upon 500 k. Now fourth one is your ballistic sensitivity. So it is defined as the first maximum deflection in mm, that is deflected in mm, caused on a scale placed at a distance of 1 meter from mirror by a unit charge. A unit charge suddenly passed in the galvanometer. When we have passed unit charge in the galvanometer, then first maximum deflection caused in mm. It is defined as SB is equals to theta upon unit charge Q. Charge is denoted as Q equals into 10 to the power 6. And putting the value of D equals to 2000 theta F, it is coming theta F upon 500 Q. And you can convert it also in the GI. Theta F equals to GI upon K. So that's all about your galvanometer constant, as D, K, G and C also, moment of inertia has been